Good morning. We're kind of staying in here where it's nice and dry this morning. It's a beautiful, rainy, thunderstormy type of day. And so here we are. And I have a couple of questions for you. What do you call a person who has been through high school, been through college, went through seminary? You call them reverend, right? Okay, then what do you call a person who's been through high school and college and medical school? You call them a doctor. Well, what do you call a person who has been through high school and college and went to law school and then gets this job as a judge? Well, you call them your honor. So you see, there's times in life when new names are given to people after they've worked long and hard and they've had some tough times getting there, but then they're doing their life's work, this job that God has lined up for them, a job that God wants them to do. Well, in Genesis 32, actually, a lot of chapters in Genesis have the story of Jacob. And Jacob was quite a character. He was kind of ornery. He didn't treat his brother right. He tricked him out of his birthright. He even tricked his own dad so he could get the blessing instead of his brother. So then he kind of ran away and he comes to this new land and he finds a woman that he loves. But then the woman's father tricks Jacob. Well, after a number of years, Jacob decides that he wants to go back home. And so, as he's going back home, one night he wrestles with God. He wrestles with God all night long, and he came through. And so, God said the next morning, "Your name is going to be Israel. I'm changing it from Jacob to Israel," which means wrestling with God. And then Jacob started this whole big family, and that is where we get the Israelites, the people of Israel. So, this story tells us there that there are some names in life that we want to strive for, that it's okay to have our names changed. I mean, and one of those names is Christian. Because you know what Christian means? Christian means that we're a follower of Christ, a follower of Jesus. We want to do what Jesus wants us to do. We want to love him. We want to worship him. We want him in our lives. And that's one of the best things to know and to be and to have your name changed to as Christian, and also to be a child of God. And it takes a lot of work. It's not easy to always make those right decisions and to be doing the right thing all the time, because sometimes we like to do things for ourselves and not think of somebody else. But that's not the way God wants us to live, is it? And so he changes our name. He changes our name to be his child. And I think that's the most wonderful, wonderful news for today. It might not be easy. That's the best name that we can have. Let's pray. Ah, dear Jesus, we just thank you for loving us so much and that we want to have our name be Christian. So work on our hearts. Help us to be your people. Help us to follow you in all ways and to just love others the way you love us. We want to live your way. And it is in your name we pray. Amen. Stay safe and stay dry and have a most wonderful day.